Hey everyone, thanks for joining us today. My name is Judah Webb. We are about to begin, but what I need from you first is to stand up on your feet and let's get ready to sing nice and loud. It's time to praise God. Come on, let's go.
Hey kids, welcome to Jesus and Me Clubhouse. I'm KC. I'm so glad you could join us today. Let's say our motto. Repeat after me. I will tell my friends.
I will tell my friends.
So they can know God.
So they can know God.
Here's something I know about God. He sent Jesus to die for us.
Oh no, somebody's dead. Matilda, call the police.
Grandpa, nobody's dead.
I heard you say somebody's dead.
We're talking about how God sent Jesus to take away our sins. The Bible says Jesus became sin for me.
Sin? What's a sin?
A sin is when we disobey God or when we don't do what the Bible teaches us to do.
Huh?
Okay, I'll give you an example. The Bible teaches us to obey our parents. So when our parents tell us to pick up our toys, what do you think God wants us to do?
Pick up your toys.
Exactly. So when we don't pick up our toys, that's a sin. Sin is just another way of saying you did something wrong.
Doing something wrong is a bad thing, isn't it?
Yes.
All these kids have sinned.
Well, the Bible says everyone has sinned.
Just what I thought. You killed somebody. Matilda, call the police.
We didn't kill anybody. God sent Jesus to take away our sins. Grandpa just doesn't understand.
Have you ever done something bad and gotten in trouble for it? Everyone has to pay for their own sin. But God loved us so much that he sent Jesus to take the punishment for our sin.
Long, long ago, the Bible does say, God promised a Savior to take sin away. A Savior so special, a hero to all. To short kids and tall kids, to big kids and small. God thought of a plan to get the job done. God's plan was simply to send us his Son. The angels were sent to announce Jesus' birth, goodwill to all men, and peace on the earth. Everything happened like God said it would, so that Jesus could teach the world God is good. He healed the sick. He made the blind see. The crippled did walk. The captive set free. He raised the dead. The deaf could now hear. He taught of God's love, and crowds gathered near. The people all loved him, except for a few. Get rid of Jesus is what we should do. They had him arrested and yelled, "Crucify!" He was hung on a cross and left there to die. Jesus was punished for your sins and mine. He said, "It is finished," and breathed his last time. Jesus had never committed a sin, but God put the sins of the whole world on him. And on that third day, Jesus rose from the grave. He defeated the devil. Our sins washed away. Then something happened to the soldier's surprise. The stone rolled away right in front of their eyes. The tomb now was empty for all men to see. Death could not keep him. Now Jesus was free. What does this mean for me and for you? God's love and goodness can finally get through. God wants to make you his child, and it's free. The price has been paid for you and for me. God so loved the world that he gave us his Son. Believe in Jesus, a new life will come. This new life's for you. It was planned from the start. Just pray and ask Jesus to live in your heart. God, thanks for loving me just like you said. Jesus died for my sins, then rose from the dead. Jesus, come into my heart, I pray. I make you the boss of my life today.
What a good thing that Jesus did for us that day. The reason that we celebrate Easter isn't because of the Easter bunny or the candy. We celebrate Easter to remember the good thing that Jesus did for you and me. And when we look at the cross, we remember that there is an empty tomb because Jesus is alive.
All right, here it is, Casey.
What is this?
A bag of trash?
Why would I want a bag of trash?
Aren't you teaching these kids how Jesus came to take away our sins?
That's right.
So, pretend that the sin is like trash that we don't want.
Okay, I'm with you.
And God takes all the trash from people's hearts, and He puts it in a big trash bag like this. And then He gave it to Jesus when He was dying on the cross.
So instead of us having a heart full of trash or sin, now our heart is clean because of Jesus.
Exactly.
Stacy, I'm really proud of you. This is a really good way to teach kids about Jesus taking away our sins.
Great. So when you're done with it, will you throw the trash away for me?
Well, I'm done with it already.
Thanks. Mom, Casey said he'd empty the trash.
Oh, I guess I'll empty the trash when I'm finished. Let's get our hearts and minds ready to learn today's Bible verse.
Sorry, I tripped on the way over.
On what, Hart?
Honestly, I don't know.
Probably on the bag of trash next to the door.
Oh, now you tell me?
I was going to tell you after I jumped over it, but you were in the middle of falling.
It's my fault. I set the trash there. I'm really sorry. Are you okay, Hart?
Yes. I'm ready to learn another Bible verse.
Okay, Hart. Today's verse is 2 Corinthians 5:21. Jesus became sin for me. Let's say it together, boys and girls. Jesus became sin.
Jesus became sin.
For me.
For me.
Okay, brain. This one is really easy today. Don't let me down.
Okay. Jesus became Cinderella.
Cinderella? Brain, that's not what Casey said.
Are you sure? You did just trip and fall. You could be confused right now.
Hart's right. Boys and girls, let's say it together. Jesus became sin.
Jesus became sin.
For me.
For me.
I've seen pictures of Jesus on the cross. He looks skinny.
Just say the Bible verse.
Jesus became thin. For me.
That's not how it goes, brain.
Let's help him, boys and girls. Jesus became sin.
Jesus became sin.
For me.
For me.
Why would Jesus become sin?
Because God wants little boys and girls to know him. But you can't really know God if your heart is full of sin.
That's right, Hart. Jesus took our sin and died on the cross so we could have a clean heart.
2 Corinthians 5:21. Jesus became sin for me.
2 Corinthians 5:21. Jesus became sin for me.
Now it's time for today's Bible story.
I can't wait to hear it.
And I can't wait to do it.
It's the hearer
and the doer
of God's word who's blessed.
They wrapped the body of Jesus in a linen cloth and laid him in a tomb. Early on Sunday morning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went out to visit the tomb. Suddenly, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and rolled aside the stone.
Who moved the stone? I can't believe the tomb is open and empty. What did they do with Jesus' body?
Don't be afraid. I know you're looking for the body of Jesus. He isn't here.
We know. The tomb is empty.
So, do you know where his body is?
He is risen from the dead. Come, see where his body was lying.
We know where his body was lying. We were here when they laid his body in this tomb. The question is, where is he now?
He is risen from the dead just as he said would happen.
Oh my, I remember that. He said he would be dead for 3 days.
You never told me that.
I didn't? He was talking once about Jonah being in the whale for 3 days. It's a long story.
Go quickly and tell Jesus' disciples that he is risen from the dead.
Wait, where is Jesus?
He told me to tell you to tell the disciples that he would meet them in Galilee.
Thank you for telling us that. Now, let's go tell the disciples.
Jesus died for our sins so that our heart could be made clean. and he could live in our heart. If you want to ask Jesus to come live in your heart, then I want to pray with you. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thanks for sending Jesus.
Thanks for sending Jesus.
To die for my sins.
To die for my sins.
Jesus, come into my heart.
Jesus, come into my heart.
Be the boss of my life.
Be the boss of my life.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Hey everyone, it's time for spiritual exercise. So up on your feet. Let me hear you nice and loud. Reach your hands up to the sky and say, I love the Lord.
I love the Lord.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
Show me your muscles. Say, God is good.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
I'm not afraid.
I'm not afraid.
For God is with me.
God is with me.
By Jesus' stripes.
By Jesus' stripes.
I am healed.
I am healed.
All right, pinky push-ups. Down, up. Down, up, say, I love others.
I love others.
Like Jesus loves me.
Like Jesus loves me.
All right, cool down stretches. Say, I obey my parents.
I obey my parents.
Other side, for it pleases God.
For it pleases God.
All right, shake it off, shake it off, shake it off. Thanks so much for joining us for the spiritual exercise. Let's make our way back to the clubhouse.
Bye. Come on. Bye.
KC, do you know what my favorite part of the clubhouse was today?
Let me guess. You liked it when Stacy tricked me into taking out the trash for her.
That too. And I liked it when Hart tripped over the trash and didn't get hurt. That was funny.
But the best part was that he didn't get hurt, Fuzzy. So what did you learn today?
The only thing worse than a worm in your apple is half a worm in your apple.
That would be pretty bad.
Yeah. What did you learn, Casey?
Jesus paid for our sins.
That's right. Jesus paid for our sins when he died on the cross.
You're right, Fuzzy. Jesus died and was buried in a tomb. How many days was Jesus in the tomb?
3.
Right again, Fuzzy. And do you know what happened after 3 days?
He got hungry and ordered pizza.
No, he didn't order pizza. He rose from the dead and walked out of that tomb.
So how did Jesus pay for our sins?
He was punished for our sins so we wouldn't be punished for them. Jesus became sin for me. 2 Corinthians 5:21. Can you say that, Fuzzy?
Jesus became sin for me. 2 Corinthians 5:21.
Very good. Well, say goodbye, Fuzzy.
Goodbye, Fuzzy.
Goodbye, kids. See you next time at the Jesus and Me Clubhouse.
Thanks so much for joining us today. I hope you had as much fun as I did. If you want to learn where you can watch more videos just like this one, be sure to follow Crosspoint Kids or Fish Bites for Kids on Facebook and YouTube. If you want to be part of our next online experience, be sure to stay tuned after this video. Thanks so much for watching today. God bless and see you next time.